All right, guys, today I'm gonna show you how to make fettuccine Alfredo. Now this is something that you'll go to a restaurant and pay, I don't know, $12 to $15 a plate for. And I'm gonna show you how to make it for about a buck. And here's what you're gonna need to make the sauce. You're gonna need a cup of milk. You're gonna need a quarter cup of flour. You're gonna need a quarter cup of butter. You're gonna need some grated cheese and a little sprinkle of salt. That's all there is to it. But more importantly, I'm going to show you how to make homemade fettuccine noodles that are the quickest and easiest noodles you're ever going to make. Because to do it, you're not going to use noodles at all. You're going to need a couple of these. Zucchinis. I'm going to show you how to make zucchini noodles because I picked up something new that I'd like to talk about. I don't do a lot of gadgets, but this one was pretty amazing. In fact, it's called the Ameza Pro. And what it does, as you can see from the box, is it allows you to shred vegetables and turn them into noodles. So when I get back, I'm going to show you how to set up the noodles, and I'm going to show you how to make this sauce. And like I said, you'll be able to have homemade fettuccine Alfredo for around a buck a serving. You can't beat it with a stick. Stand by. Clear some of this junk out of the way here. And I'm going to show you how this noodle maker works. All right, the first thing you'll notice when you get it comes in a box. So I'm going to open up the box. So you can get a few things. I'll give you a little ball cap here. Got no idea what that's for. We'll get rid of that. This cap you will need. This is what you use on the base of your zucchini so you can hold it. And then you get this little thing here, which is basically a grater. One side will do thin spaghetti-like noodles, and the other side will do thicker fettuccine noodles. We're going to use the thicker side. And then you get this little doohickey here, which you can use to clean it out between uses. So the first thing we do is we get this out of the way, and we take our zucchinis, break out a knife, and we just cut off the top and the bottom, like so. Nothing to it. We'll do it on both of those. Okay, then you take your noodle maker, and you take Mr. Cap, and you put the cap on the bottom that'll hold the noodle, and then you stick the zucchini into the shredder. You hold it like so, and you just start to spin it. And what will happen is noodles, as you can see, will start to come out. And you just keep turning that one continuous noodle until you get the cap all the way down into the base. And as you can see, one nice size zucchini will probably make enough for one serving of fettuccine. And then you just keep turning until you can turn it no further, and it's still going down, and it's still producing noodles. And eventually, it'll run out of gas, and at that point, you pull out the plug. And what I usually do, I don't waste it. I'm just going to take it, I'm going to cut the base off, and I'm going to slice this thing into several rounds that I'll saute on the side. There you have it. I'll be right back after I do the next setup. All right, here we are, we're back. As you can see, I've got enough fettuccine for two, or should I say zucchini. And before you know it, I'll show you how to set those up in this saute pan. But before we do that, I want to get our sauce cooking. To do that, we're going to come over here to Mr. Pot. And to start off with, I'm going to turn a bit of a fire underneath him. Okay. And I'm going to take a spatula and put in my butter. And I'm going to mix that up until I get it. You'll have to turn down this flame a little bit. You don't want to kill it, but we want to melt it. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to melt this butter down, and then once the butter gets melted down, I'm going to put some flour in it to thicken it up. And then we'll add our cream and our cheese to make our Alfredo sauce. Really, there's nothing else to it. All right. And then slowly we're going to start adding in our flour a little bit at a time, because again, you want to make a sauce, you don't want to make sludge. And the trick is to let the butter merge with the flour. The trick is to turn it into, is not to let it get too thick. I think that's about all I'm going to do right now. I don't necessarily have to use it all. Then I'm going to add the milk. And if you've done this properly, what will happen is the milk and the butter and the flour will all merge. And this is just to help us make the base for the sauce. And then we're going to add our grated cheese, which in my case is a mixture of Parmesan and Romano. You can use either Parmesan, Romano, Locatelli, whatever you happen to have. You just want to have a nice Italian hard cheese. And if you do detect any little lumps on the side, take care of them like so. Once the milk comes up to a bubble, that'll also help to melt the last of the flour butter into the milk. All right, and then I'm just going to add a little bit of thyme. I will do it like this. A couple of hits of the cheese, right? A little dash of salt. And that's all there is to it. And then the trick is just to let it come up to a slow boil. And again, anytime you're working with milk, you must constantly stir it or you run the risk of burning it, which is not the desired result. Here we go. Now she's starting to bubble. And as it starts to bubble, she'll start thickening as well. Just a little bit more of the cheese in there, and we should be good to go. Now, if for some reason it's not thick enough, you don't want to be using raw flour. That's why I recommend that you get a little bit of this stuff. It's called Wondra. And what Wondra is, it's gravy flour. I'm just going to add just a little more flour to the mix. But I don't want to add regular flour because it will definitely start to lump. We don't want to lump this up. Just a little bit more, almost there. Again, you'll know when it's done. And I'm going to turn this way down now. Because now we've got it really bubbling nicely. Just want to have a barely... There you go. There you go. Starting to thicken. There you are. Give it another couple of stirs. We should have us some nice fettuccine Alfredo sauce. There you are. Perfect. All right, now I'll show you how to get the fettuccine up to speed. Now, if this was a marinara sauce, what I would do is just put you can put the noodles right in and then just use a fork or a spaghetti fork to pull them back out. But because this is a white sauce, I don't want to put it in the white sauce. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to heat up the pan over there. Okay. There we go. And I'm going to throw some olive oil in once it gets nice and hot. Let it heat up for a second. Like I said, you always want to let the pan get hot, then add the oil, not the other way around. There we go. There you are. All right, what I like to do is start off with just a little bit of garlic. So I'll put the garlic in there and we're gonna let that sizzle for a second or two. Let's get that going. And then what you do is you just toss your noodles in, give them a couple of tosses in the oil with the garlic, right? All there is to it. There you go. And then what we're going to do is we're going to plate it. Then all you need to do is give it a little hit of pepper and you're good to go. Fettuccine Alfredo for a dollar a holler. You saw it here first on Man Cave Munchies.